I'll just set it up. Do I need to raise that up?
No, you got, you're good, man. You're in good shape. You can hear. Just, you got enough microphone over there.
You know, there's one thing that I don't think, if you really get saved, you will remember the time and the place. I gave my heart to the Lord back probably 1945 or 6 or something were in that time frame, and in Texas. And I could tell you and show you right back today the place that the Lord saved my soul.
Amen.
Grip on his mind, and he had less on his fingers. But anyway, we are
Lord,
here.
Lord's gonna bless you to get through this.
Yeah.
I believe it.
Yeah. Honey, you just keep that.
And I'm older than he is.
Well, I'm almost a whole lot older. She won't tell that. money is one of the most dreadful downfalls that we have in our society today. And that's sad. Because this is a song that I learned to sing when I sung with the quartet. And it's still real today. And I guess you've heard it. I mean, I know you've heard it. Heard a lot of different quartet singing. Poor rich man. We're having many. There are some who say we cannot tell. Well, the Lord is saved, God. Well, all is well. They say we only have to stand in His soul. Well, that happened, and I guess I it's got an ending to it. When the end came, I was going to quit and go back to Poor Rich Man.
Let's do Poor Rich Man. Yes, they don't know that.
Y'all thought I was, you know, just putting on, didn't you? We often judge a man by the clothes he wears, or the thoughts he drives. And he can use the devil if he's doing very well by the house he's living in. Well, I am here to say, I know you, because
special. I wanted to sing one morning. They had theirs, so I said, okay. I told Mr. Wilbur, I said, you sit right there. I'm going first. Because I ain't about to follow y'all around this place. And then I walked out of the church, and this good friend walked, put his arm around me, and he said, I'm glad you did that. That proves you're not as dumb as I thought you were.
Oh, my good evening, folks.
Y'all do better than that.
Good evening, folks.
Good evening.
A little bit better now. At least you actually got a little bit of life in you. I know how it is on Sunday evening. I get it. But, you know, we're here today. We're here today to do two things. First and foremost, to celebrate and worship our Lord and Savior.
Amen.
Every time we come in the house, that'll be our first goal. Celebrate and worship our Lord and Savior.
Amen.
We're excited for that. Excited to have the Lancasters up here saying one of my favorite people in the world. Love them to death. We're excited to have Cross Ties here with us tonight. We like them, okay? Love them to death as well. And glad they're here tonight. We're here. This is our love home now. What we're doing tonight, we're loving on the family. God puts people in your path for reasons. We don't ever understand. But you know, he ties us all together for a reason.
Yes.
And when one family,
amen,
goes through a hard time,
oh, yeah,
the rest of us spoke rally up around them,
amen,
and help them.
Amen.
Bible teaches that, y'all ain't never read it.
Amen.
So that's what we're here to do tonight. We're here just to love on a family, Mike and Donna Harris, Mike battling liver cancer, and got to make a trip out to Houston again next week, and we just want to help them a little bit. And glad to have their whole family here tonight, sitting here. And it might get so exciting in here in a little bit. Me and Matt and Jake may sing a trio. You can't ever tell. But we're excited they're here tonight. And I'm sorry a little bit for the hustle and bustle. We had a silent auction going in the fellowship hall today. And they've been there, people in and out over there. And they're still over there trying to get some things situated over there. So we're excited. You know, the Lord just does things for reasons. And when June called me and he said, Johnny Ann can come on March the 10th. Okay, that's good. And we began to pray about it, and all of a sudden found out Mike and Nolan was going back to Houston on March 16th. I thought, well, God just laid that out there, didn't he? I mean, he just timed that. And I began to look at the timing that God laid in that, and I said, wow. I said, June, I gotta do something, he told me. And I told him, we talked about it, and he said, absolutely. So tonight is a love on night for Mike and Donna, benefit night, and we're loving on them and their families tonight just to help with that. Y'all know medical expenses, boy, they get up in a hurry, and just to help on that with them. So we're excited tonight. So what we're going to do when I get done preaching, Kevin, you know how it is, don't you, Kevin? You just get a little excited, and you just got to go with it. But we're excited tonight. We're going to have a word of prayer. And we're going to turn it over to Johnny and them and let them do what they do so well. And we're just excited. So I want you to be excited. So here's what you're going to do before we get started, okay? Everybody raise your hand. Got this one up? Everybody got this one up? You know Simon didn't say to do that. Just check. If this is the way you worship, this is what's called worship mode. So when you get excited in the Lord tonight and the Lord gets to working and moving on you tonight, don't be afraid to raise it. I know the biggest part of us is Baptist, all of us ain't. Don't be afraid to raise it, and it's okay to do that. So now you're practiced. Now you know what to do. So now we're going to pray. Let's pray together. Father, we love you so much, Lord. We thank you for the opportunity tonight. Lord, I thank you for being just a great God. If you didn't do another thing for us, Father, you've done more than we deserve. More than we deserve. And tonight, Father, we just want to celebrate your goodness, celebrate your faithfulness, celebrate your love for us. And Lord, we just want to be quick to give you the glory. Lord, tonight, Father, as Johnny and the Cross Ties come to sing, thank you for anointing them. Thank you for anointing the sweet Lancasters, Father, as they stood and sang. But Lord, we want to all come here tonight, this whole church, as a whole group, as a whole. Father, we want to enter that threshold together. We want to enter that threshold of worship. Lord, that threshold of love and grace, Father, we want to enter that together tonight. Lord, we just give you all the praise. We love you, and we thank you tonight. Hold this name and pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Johnny, it's all yours.
Which we appreciate, but we don't want y'all to get tired of us. So David brings a little something different to us. So.
Real different. He didn't say good or bad, did he?
But we want to kind of start off, wow, what a singing church this is. And we were just singing the song at the opening. I thought, wow, what a group of singers, and y'all just raise the roof. So here's what you can all raise the roof on. I'll fly away. That's how it feels.
Stop it, smell the blues from the ground. We have a
And a lot of you folks were there. We really appreciate that so much. And they've always been one of my favorite groups from way, way back. And we do a song that they do that is also one of my favorites. The songs that they do, whichever one they happen to be doing, that happens to be my favorite one. It changes a lot. This is a little song that talks about the Lord's coming back again. It says, if you know Him as your Savior, then you can sing this song. It'll be all right with me. Thank you.
retirement life. I recommend it.
Well, we got the banjo, obligatory banjo. Singings, which everybody loves, and I think there's going to be another one this weekend at Sardis, down below Bible. I think they want me to announce that. It's 5 o'clock this coming Saturday, so if you can go to that, I'm sure they would appreciate it. But this is a good old song. It says, I'm getting ready to leave this world.
All right.
Thank you.
the percussion. He's usually playing the guitar, but he's one of the best percussion guys I know. I don't know a whole lot of them. No, I don't mean that. Said we enjoy doing a lot of different styles of music. One of those is the old timey Sacred Harp shaped note singing, and a lot of those old Sacred Harp songs came from Irish and Scots fiddle tunes, and they took them and adapted them to sacred lyrics and married them together and put them in the Sacred Harp songbook. So we thought, well, let's pull a few of those out and try to do a little medley of those songs. And we call this one the Rocky Road Set, and that's because we wind up singing the Rocky Road.
Thank you. that was the equivalent of somebody really getting down on the guitar, but it was funny.
For some reason this week, I looked up, my son told me about this AI thing that you didn't hear about. And so I looked up on that. I asked the question, I said, what percentage of the population are banjo players? And it come back and it says, there's not really any data on banjo players, but you can tell you there's about 1.5 to 2% of people who are musicians in the United States. I thought, wow, that's something. That's pretty good, pretty select company, you know, there. I can't remember exactly what it was. Randy said something on the text. Do you remember what it was?
Yeah, I said, I wonder what the percentage of musicians in the United States play the spoons.
That's right.
So, yeah, he got me there on the banjo.
I'm just glad they categorize that as a musician. So. I'll take it.
I said that because you play guitar.
Okay, all right.
David, you want to decide on shut the door?
Yeah.
Go down to the islands. Shut the door, keep out the devil. Shut the door, keep the devil in the night. Shut the door, keep out the devil. Light the candle, everything's all right. Light the candle, everything's all right. Now when I was a baby child.
Shut the door, keep out the devil.
Good and bad was just a game.
Shut the door, keep the devil in the night.
Many years and many trials.
Here. Have y'all ever seen a more talented group of people?
Oh, no.
welcome to slip out and look at and look and see if you want to. Be fine. So you can see that. But thank you so much for being here tonight. Thank you guys. As always, you do an awesome job. So we're thrilled and thrilled and thrilled. Let me see why I'm so thrilled, because God gets the glory. Amen. He gets all the glory. So we're thrilled for that tonight. So we're going to pray tonight. These guys will come around. If you feel that, give something, don't. That's okay. That's okay. We're going to let God give. He still will give the glory. He still gets the glory. So let's pray together. Father, we love you. Father, we thank you again for the opportunity to be here tonight. Lord, thank you for each one that's gathered here, Lord. And Lord, we have entered that threshold together. We've entered that threshold of worship together, Father. And Lord, I tell you, our lives will be better for you because you are our God. Lord, tonight, I just thank you so much for what we've accomplished here, Lord. Thank you for being here with us tonight. Thank you for this group that's here. And God, we just thank you, Father, for that loving heart of each one here, Father. Be with us tonight, Father. You get the glory. Lord, just thank you, pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
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 All right.
This is by the way, if you'll check your printed program.
punchline.
Yeah, I was.
That was it.
Y'all love this season.
Amen.
Yes.
Man, everything's starting to bud out. You know, it's not quite sneezing season yet, so it's still beautiful out there. This song just claims that. This is my Father's work.
Oh, man.
Sings the round and things, the music of the spheres. This is my Father's world. The birds and carols raise the morning light, the midnight, declare the Maker's praise. This is my Father's world. I rest me in the in a piano recital. I played La Cucaracha. It's the last time I ever sat down at a piano. But I just wanted to do a couple of verses here. 454. We're going to start on the chorus, Miss Ladies. She doesn't even. All right, give us another intro on the chorus.
chorus. Here we go.
Yeah.
one that was written, I think, around 1906 or 1907 by a lady named Ada Habershine. And then the Carter family took the song in the 30s, might have been in the 20s, and made it kind of into a popular country song, changed the lyrics on it. But we like the original lyrics. So, talks about those who don't own the forest and the fact that we can go to be with them at one of these days. The old song entitled, "Will the Serpent Be Unrolled?"
Seatbelt on songs. And I don't know if this is our last one or not, but it is called "When My Time Comes to Go." When my time comes to go. Lay my head on Jesus' rest when my time comes to go.
this is. This is an Irish bouzouki, originally a Greek instrument, so it's a Greek name, bouzouki. We like to tell the story that whenever we go through airports, we be careful not to call it a bouzouki. Some reason it gets held up, when we call it that. But it's basically like an octave mandolin, just a longer neck than a mandolin, tuned a little bit differently. But Brett's going to play his Irish drum here on this one. Song we do entitled The Joy of My Life.
Pleasing, I love thee the best without thee.
special for you, Miss Nancy. That's she loves you that old whistle.
Gospels a lot about the crucifixion, but did you ever think about what the soldiers saw? This song asks that question. Soldiers picked up their hammers and they nailed into the tree, and the nails in his hands and feet were meant for me. And as he hung there in agony, they mocked him in his pain, and for his tears and his blood I held myself to blame. Soldiers guarded his grave site and they sealed his death with stone, and they laughed about the latest cult they'd overthrown, and they wondered why they were sent there just to guard those lifeless bones, when the promise of salvation he spoke of was dead and gone. But I wonder what the soldiers saw when the stone was rolled away, and I wonder just what happened as Easter dark turned into day. Was Mary the first to see our risen Savior? Did the soldiers see salvation face to face? Soldiers were there at Pentecost and were touched with tongues of flame, and the Spirit gave them power beyond what man could claim. Our Savior was proclaimed, and you and I receive salvation through his name. Wonder where the world would be if the soldiers had not been there, and I wonder where the church would be if they hadn't. Where would you and I be now if they had not dared to share? If they'd said this cross is just too much to bear? So soldiers, pick up your hammers, drive true and let them ring. This salvation, your foundation, and Jesus. Their love, their lives, their home.
pages on the songs of faith in any book. Probably only in a book here, but aren't you glad for the victory that only Jesus can give?
Amen.
And it's because of that victory we're all able to be here this evening. Thank you for inviting us up. And I think I've introduced some of the guys. I haven't introduced the big guy right here, Mr. Randy Garrett. When we got to go to Germany, he was always introduced as the Grossmann.
I'm offended.
Very appropriate. But I didn't decline on mine. No, it was small. I used to be big. So, anyway, my name is Johnny Wright, and I think we got everybody else.
Yeah.
So we are the Cross Ties Band, and I'm grateful to be here with you this evening. We always like to joke around on this one. Half joke and say, we're going to do it bluegrass style. That's the way they do it in heaven.
I thought I was going to say something about us. We do it lower every time because they're getting old and our voices are down.
That's true. But maybe it's not. We're not with this one. So. But y'all help us out if you will on this song. We'll do this one with one more. Appreciation to Antioch to be here tonight. We really appreciate that.
Thank you all.
And Brother Gene asked us to end up with a song. It's a very special song to a lot of people, especially if you're in need of prayer, as we saw a little bit ago, standing there in need of prayer, to know that there's somebody praying for you. And, you know, just because we're Christians, we're not immune to the troubles and the trials of the world, not immune to sickness, not immune to, you know, problems going on in our family or financial problems, that sort of thing. But the Lord does promise that he'll be there to go through those with us. And that's what this song is about, that Randy's going to sing to us in time. Somebody's praying for me.
Thank you.
Fellowship pile, they got your names listed on the stuff over there. If you want it,